Hey guys, in this clap we'll be seeing one of the most interesting applications of relative speed, which is nothing but problems on trains. So whatever problems on trains you face, I'll be sharing you four cases. Those problems will come under only these four cases. Okay, first case is a train crossing a stationary object without length. A train has got a length of L and a speed of S. Now the question goes like this: what is the time taken to cross this object, be it a tree or a stationary flag pole or electric post, something like that? So time taken is distance by speed. What is the distance covered here? See, when the front end of the train touches this tree, we can say it has started crossing. When the back end comes here, we can say it has finished crossing, right? So in this transaction, the distance covered is the train's own length. So distance covered is equal to L by S. This is case number one. Case number two is a train crossing a stationary object with length. So train's length is L1, this is L2. In this case, the time taken is equal to L1 plus L2 by S, because it has to cross the bridge as well as it has to come outside. So it can be a bridge or a platform or a tunnel or another standing train, something like that. So L1 plus L2 by S. Third case is a train crossing a moving object without length. So train's speed is S1, the boy's speed is S2, train's length is L. So the boy is coming in the opposite direction of the train in the railway track. So time taken to cross or meet each other is L by S1 plus S2. Why plus S2? Because opposite direction, so relative speed is plus. If the boy is riding a bicycle in the same direction of the train, means it is S1, difference S2. Okay, fourth case is a train crossing another moving object with length. So if this is going to be L1 of length, this is L2, and if this is S1, this is S2. When they're coming in opposite directions, we can say time taken is equal to L1 plus L2 by S1 plus S2, since they are moving in the opposite direction. This is case number four. So based on four cases, we will start solving problems. The first problem for you guys is a train 150 meter long travels at 60 km per hour. How long does it take to cross a telegraph post? So time taken is equal to, telegraph post means case number one, right? So length of the train L by S. So length of the train, distance is the length of the train 150 by speed is 60. Remember, the speed is given in kilometer per hour. So we have to convert into meter per second. So 60 into 5 by 18. 5 by 18. 60 into 5 by 18. So 150 by 300 gives you 1 by 2. 18 by 2. So answer is 9 seconds. Answer is 9 seconds. Second case is a man running at 6 km in the same direction. So case number 3. Time taken is equal to 150 by train speed is 60. Man speed is 6. Same direction. So 60 different 6 is 54. 54 into 5 by 18, which is nothing but 3 into 15, 10 seconds. So the answer for second case is 10 seconds. Now the third and the fourth case. A train crossing a platform. Platform means, like, this is case number 2. So train length, platform length by train speed I have converted here. So when you solve this, 400 by 300 into 18. So 4 by 3 into 18, nothing but 24 seconds. 24 seconds is the answer for this problem. And fourth is a train crossing another train 1 centimeter long, running in the same direction. So case number 4, right? 150, 170. Length of one train, length of the other train. And difference of the speeds. Why difference? Because same direction here. So 60, 54 difference is 6. 6 into 5 by 18. Why 5 by 18? For the conversion. So 320 by 6 into 5 by 18. 6 into 5 by 18 means 5 by 3. So 320 into 3 by 5. So 64 into 3, answer is 192 seconds. 192 seconds. Hope this application of relative speed problems on trains is much clear to you now. Thank you.